Welcome to Springs Kids. I'm Miranda.
And I'm Petra. We are so glad that you are joining us today.
If you are 4 or 5 years old, this is for you.
We'd love to have you check out one of our Kinderchurch classes in Winnipeg or Calgary.
You'll have so much fun playing games,
doing praise and worship,
and learning a brand new lesson from the Bible every week.
Each week, we talk about something really important to us. Laugh!
We spell it a bit differently. Here, we spell it L-A-F, because each letter stands for something really important to us.
L stands for love. We want to make sure that we are loving others the same way that Jesus first loved us.
A stands for accept. God made everyone unique and special, and we want to accept everyone the way they are.
The last letter is F, and it stands for forgive. Everyone makes mistakes, and it's important that when we make mistakes, we're quick to forgive because we love one another.
Like when someone takes a toy from you without asking. Instead of getting angry, we should forgive our friend and nicely ask for it back.
Yes, that's right. And if our friend doesn't give our toy back, we can always ask an adult for help.
We've got an awesome lesson prepared for you this week. Let's all stand up so we can start with praise and worship.
The good news, there is somebody who loves you. His name is Jesus, he is the one. Born on Christmas, we're gonna have some fun. From the back of the room, all the way to the front. Wherever you are, come on and jump, jump, jump. Sing it, hey, everybody, come on and lift your hands. Sing it, hey, everybody, it's time to sing it.
Hi everyone, this month we're learning that God gave us Jesus. The Bible verse we'll be learning today will help us remember that Jesus is a gift to us. It says, God loved the world so much that he gave his only son, John 3:16. The Bible teaches us that God loves us so much that he gave us his only son, Jesus. Let's stand up together and say the verse with the actions. Just say what I say and do what I do. God loved the world so much that he gave his only son. John 3:16. That's awesome. I love learning about what the Bible has to teach us. I can't wait to hear what else we'll learn in today's lesson. I think our clubhouse friends are ready. Let's watch.
Ooh, ooh. You know what time it is?
It's time to hear a story full of wonder. There's so much fun we'll have learning together. So let's go down to the clubhouse with Ollie and his friends. Let's go down, down, down to the clubhouse where wonder never ends at the Wonder Clubhouse.
Me and you
at the Wonder Clubhouse.
Me and you.
Oh, hi friends, I'm Luca. Check out our awesome train. My dad helped me make it, but I think we can make it even more fun with special decorations. Here we go. Ta-da! I think it's time for All Aboard! Oh wait, we don't know where we're going yet. Where should we go? This train is so fancy. We could drive to a sparkly big castle. Or we could go to a super fancy dinner. And it definitely seems like we should be driving to meet someone super important. Oh, I know. We can drive this fancy train to meet someone super important at a sparkly castle to eat a super fancy dinner.
Who? Who?
It's Ollie.
Hello, Luca. Who? Who? Going somewhere important, are you?
Oh, hi, Ollie. My train is so cool. I want to drive it someplace awesome and fancy.
That's a great idea. It's true. But places that aren't fancy can be important, too. Listen to this story. Just follow me through.
Follow me through. Follow me through. Ollie's got a Bible story for me and you.
Oh, hello, friends. Merry almost Christmas to you. I'm Carrie the dog walker, and this is my best dog. Sorry. Best train conducting assistant, Stormy Jane. And we want to know if you're ready to learn the next part of the true story of Christmas. I think that means Stormy's ready. Well, the Christmas train is coming to help me tell today's true story from the Bible. If you're ready to board the Christmas story train, on the count of three, say all aboard. Ready? One, two, three. All aboard! The true story of Christmas begins with a young girl named Mary. God sent an angel with an important message for Mary. The angel said that Mary was going to have a baby, and that baby would be Jesus, God's son. Wow, God loves us so much that he gave us his son, Jesus. Well, not long after that, Mary and Joseph had to travel a long way to the town of Bethlehem. Can you guess what animal Mary might have been riding? There's Joseph and Mary. Stormy Jane, you're not supposed to be in the story, silly dog. Back up, let's try that again. So there's Joseph and Mary. And what animal is Mary riding? Yes, a donkey, that's right. Can everyone say, hee-haw, hee-haw? Ready? Hee-haw, hee-haw. Very good. When Mary and Joseph got to Bethlehem, they needed to find a place to stay and quick. Jesus, God's son, was about to be born. Now tell me, is Jesus being born a little special or a big whole lot of special? Yes, Jesus being born is a big whole lot of special. So where did Mary and Joseph stay? Did they stay somewhere fancy like a giant castle? No. Or did they stay somewhere not fancy, like a stable full of animals? Yep, that's where they stayed. It wasn't fancy. What was that? A chicken? Can you make a sound like a chicken? And that's not all. There were sheep. Can you make a sheep sound? Baa. Ready? Baa. Wait. Everybody stop and listen. Shh. What's that sound? It's not a sheep. What is it? Yes. It's a baby. Baby Jesus was born. And Mary wrapped him up and she placed him in a manger full of straw. Jesus, God's son, had been born. God gave us Jesus. Oh, that's the whistle. It means it's time for the Christmas story train to leave. But it'll be back because there's more to the true story of Christmas. Oh, hey there, Ollie. Ollie, tell me, how do we know God loves us?
God gave us Jesus. Yes, it's true. Now let's hear it from you. Tell me, how do we know God loves us?
God gave us Jesus. That's the truth, friends. See you next time. Bye.
So there's your story, and it's all true. Jesus wasn't born somewhere fancy, but he's the most special gift for me and you.
Thanks, Ollie.
Goodbye to you. Hoo, hoo.
Wow! Jesus wasn't born somewhere fancy, but Jesus is special because Jesus is God's son. God loves us so much, he gave us Jesus. I think I got the story. Did you get it? If you did, say got it. Get it?
Got it!
Good. I don't have to drive somewhere fancy for it to still be special. So, all aboard. See you next time. Chugga, 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 choo, choo.
Jesus.
Hey guys, I'm so glad you joined us here today. We love learning about God, how much He loves us, and the amazing things He wants us to do. Did you know that you are loved so much by God that He sent His Son Jesus to die on a cross? He died, but He is such a hero, the best and true hero, that He defeated death, came back to life, and He wants to be our best friend forever and ever. How amazing is that? Now we're gonna pray a super awesome prayer right now where we can ask Him to be with us forever, to be our best friend and to help us be superheroes too. With God in our hearts, we can live the best life possible. We can be brave, we can be strong, we can have joy and peace. He gives us healing when we're sick, is a friend when we're lonely, and gives us blessings so amazing we can't even imagine. That was so cool. Let's pray. Dear Jesus, thank you for dying on a cross for me and coming back to life to be my forever friend. I want to live for you, follow you, and love you forever and ever. Please come into my life. Help me to learn and grow every day to be more like you. Amen. Wow, I am so glad you prayed that prayer with me. If you don't have a Bible at home, you can ask your parents to contact us and we'll send you one. And don't forget to tell them to subscribe to our YouTube channel so you don't miss a thing. Have an awesome week and we'll see you next time. Bye.